Finally, we're going to talk about formal charge. But for the moment, let's ignore that, and let's just work on the Lewis structure for carbon dioxide. Carbon is the central atom. Put the two oxygens around carbon. You know, it doesn't have to be like this. You could do it, you know, vertically. However, the Lewis structure doesn't tell you the shape. You have to wrap something around the Lewis structure in order to get the shape. For valence count, carbon is column 4A and oxygen is column 6A. There are two of them. 16 electrons divided by 2. We have 8 pair to distribute. So we'll bond up the oxygens to carbon. Then we'll go after each of the surrounding oxygens to get an octet. So add 3 pair to that oxygen. Add 3 more pair to this oxygen. And that's 8. We're out. Okay, so the carbon, the central atom, it has fewer than 4 pair, but you can't do this. Why can't you do this? Yeah, you're out of electrons. You can't just magically introduce more electrons. We have 8 pair. At this point, we've distributed 8 pair. So you remember what we've done before. You play the multiple bonding game. So I need to borrow a pair of electrons. I'll borrow from the oxygen on the right-hand side. Now before, we made one multiple bond and we're done. That's not necessarily the case. You keep multiple bonding until you get the central atom up to 4. So we only have 3 pair. So what should we do? Do you want to do a triple bond with the oxygen on the right? Or do you want to do a double bond with the oxygen on the left? Yeah, most people right now would say, oh, I want to do a double bond with the other oxygen. Okay. So we take that, borrow it, turn that into a double bond, and then we get this. And people usually want to do that because they say, well, it's two double bonds. It seems better than a triple and a single bond. Okay, and that's not a good enough answer. You can't just choose to do this because it looks better. See, we could have done this. There's not a rule, as far as we know yet, that says you can't do a triple bond and a single bond. And in fact, we could have done a triple bond with the left oxygen and a single bond with the right oxygen. Okay, actually, that's not a different structure. Look, those bottom two are really the same thing. You're just flipping the middle one around to turn it into the bottom one. So let's take that bottom one away. So how do we decide which of these two is the better Lewis structure? That's where formal charge comes in. Formal charge is, in some ways, similar to oxidation numbers. So if you recall, when we did oxidation numbers, back when we were studying oxidation reduction, you assign the oxidation number for each atom in the chemical species, and the rules were heavily biased towards ions. In other words, assuming that most of the atoms behaved like ions. Formal charge goes the other way. Formal charge assumes that all the electrons in bonds are equally shared between the atoms, regardless of their electronegativities. So if you have a pair of electrons shared between a carbon and an oxygen, you assume that pair, from an electron density point of view, is the same around the carbon as around the oxygen, and there's no difference. Okay, well, it's not really the case for many of them because you do have to worry about electronegativity. So think of oxidation numbers as one end of the spectrum and formal charge as the other end of the spectrum. Oxidation numbers, everything's an ion. Formal charge, everything's equally shared. Now to calculate the formal charge for an atom, you need a formula. So the formal charge is equal to, well, you look at the atom and the chemical species, and first you figure out the number of valence electrons it has. That's the same as we've been doing. Then you look at it and you count the number of non-bonding electrons around that atom. You know, the number of lone pair electrons. And then you look at the bonding electrons it's sharing with another atom and divide it by 2. And that's your formal charge. And you do that for every atom in the chemical species. So the left one is my 2 double bonded structure for carbon dioxide, and the right one is my single and triple bond. So let's work on the left one first. And when I calculate the formal charge for one oxygen, it'll be the same for the other oxygen because it's double bonded to the carbon. Oxygen's column 6A, 6 valence electrons. On that oxygen, there are 4 non-bonding electrons. It's the actual count for the number of electrons and not the number of pair. And then, that oxygen is sharing 4 electrons with the other carbon. 4 divided by 2 is 2. Or you can think of it as that 2 comes from 2 bonds with the other atom. And that gives a formal charge of 0 for that oxygen. Do the same thing for carbon. Column 4A, 4 valence electrons. There are no non-bonding or lone pair electrons on carbon, so that's a 0. And then 2, 4, 6, 8 divided by 2, it's sharing 8 electrons with the 2 oxygens divided by 2, that's 4, or there are 4 bonds. And that means carbon has an oxidation number of 0. Now, just like oxidation numbers, all the formal charges have to add up to whatever the charge is on that chemical species. So what's the charge on carbon dioxide? Well, yeah, there's nothing listed, so it's a 0. So you got a 0 for both oxygens and a 0 for carbon. Well, that all adds up to 0. All right, let's go after the one on the right. I did a subscript of A just to distinguish the two oxygens from each other. So that leftmost oxygen, column 6A for valence electrons. There are 2, 4, 6 non-bonding electrons around it. And it's sharing a pair with the carbon, so that's 2 divided by 2. There's a 1, or 1 bond. And you get a formal charge of negative 1 for that oxygen. Then for carbon, it's column 4A, 4 valence electrons. There are 0 non-bonding electrons around that carbon. And 2, 4, 6, 8 divided by 2, that's a 4, or 4 bonds. And that's a 0. The rightmost oxygen, column 6A, 6 valence electrons. There are 2 non-bonding electrons on that oxygen. And it's sharing 6 electrons with the carbon. 6 divided by 2 is 3, or 3 bonds. And that gives me a plus 1 for the formal charge. And if you add up those 3 formal charges, negative 1, 0, plus 1 adds up to 0, because again, carbon dioxide is neutral, so the charge is 0. So look at these two. The one on the left, all the formal charges are 0. The one on the right, we have 1, 0, 1 with a negative 1, and 1 with a positive 1. So your first pass when comparing structures, you take the Lewis structure that has more formal charges that are equal to 0. That means the leftmost Lewis structure is a better structure from a formal charge argument. And that's why you do 2 double bonds instead of a single bond and a triple bond.